technology advances are augmenting how we are working, and to great benefit. But the shift can be unsettling. Transformation isn't easy, and change is often not painless. It is necessary, however, for businesses looking to stay competitive, particularly in the era of AI. Now, the power of these tools, particularly AI-powered tools, is only as strong as the human user's willingness and ability to work with them. So today, we're going to talk about three use cases of how AI is augmenting the human efforts in the workplace. Let's first meet Susan. Susan is an administrative assistant at a law firm. Now, this firm has recently introduced some AI-powered tools to help their employees. Susan's a little worried, however, because she's not sure how this is augmenting her work. She's worried it's replacing her entirely. Good news is Susan actually doesn't have to be worried, because while AI is going to help with manual tasks and time-intensive tasks like data entry or even data processing, Susan is still vitally important to the company. She has to provide the context and strategy around how to use this data to benefit the business. And when it comes to helping clients, well, sure, the AI-powered chatbot can provide some quick answers to easy questions, but what about when there's a bigger issue and you need that human empathy and compassion to really help make sure the business and the client are successful? Well, that is where Susan shines. For our second use case, let's meet Ben. He's an IT systems manager at a tech company, so he understands a lot about the AI era and both the challenges, risks, and benefits of artificial intelligence. Now, he's a little hesitant adding even more AI-powered tools to his tech stack, but he knows that there are going to be some massive benefits if he has more AI augmenting his team. For instance, AI is going to be able to bring a level of speed to enhance systems management processes and 24/7 security monitoring, which means that they can catch issues even faster. Now, does that mean that Ben and his team are irrelevant? Absolutely not, because first of all, Ben has to review any of the AI outputs to make sure that they are not biased or hallucinations. He then also has to be able to respond and direct his team to respond in ways that are appropriate for the company and for the clients. And while AI is certainly helping his team be more productive because of the pace at which it can gather and analyze data, Ben and his team, well, they're the ones who have to create and iterate solutions and improvements that are going to positively impact the business. For our third use case, I'd like to introduce you to Barb. They're a customer support rep at a major retail company. This company has recently started using an AI-powered assistant as the first line of defense in customer support. Barb is very curious about how this assistant is augmenting their work, and so at a recent employee training, learned a few things. For instance, the assistant can help provide that 24/7 always-on support that customers are expecting more and more of today. It can also help with quick answers and speed in responses to commonly asked questions. And finally, well, the AI has a lot of customer data that it can parse through very quickly in order to allow for things like personalization in responses. Again, something that customers are expecting more and more of today. So where does that leave Barb? Well, they have the skill for complexity. So when you have customers who have issues that can't be solved with speed or frequently asked questions, you want someone who can deal with the complex scenarios. You also want someone who can be strategic and innovative. with their solutions and really apply the data, not just in an A plus B manner, but think broadly and understand the causality. Finally, Barb can provide compassion. Now, when it comes to customer support, nothing could take the place of the fact that a person on one end of the phone can understand and provide compassion for the person who feels like they are in crisis on the other end of the phone. As you can see, all of these are somewhat similar to other examples from Susan and Ben. Barb, Ben, and Susan all bring a level of humanity to these AI-powered tools, and their businesses need them. Now that we've looked at use cases from Susan, Ben, and Barb, how can you make sure that you're set up for success when it comes to using AI to augment your work? Well, I would suggest you start with strategy. You want to define your objectives. Why are you using AI tools? And what is it you're hoping to get from them? You also need to assess the data and the technology that's supporting and helping to train and run the AI. This is how you know that it's trustworthy. Speaking of trustworthy, you also want to make sure that you have a data strategy in place, because governance is crucial when it comes to ensuring that you can not only trust the AI, but that you are operating ethically. Now, if you're really nervous and don't really understand the technology, well, I would suggest making sure that you're ready with skill building, either upskilling or reskilling, to see how AI can be integrated or is already being integrated into tools and processes that you know and love. Finally, start small. Test with a pilot and scale as you are able with proof points and more confidence. You as a practitioner can embrace AI in your workplace. It can augment your efforts and bolster the future of work for all of us, all while keeping you, the employee, front and center for the business. After all, machines and AI, sure, they provide productive scalability, but we provide essential contextual human capabilities.